Delta.time, what is up guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. Today we're going to do a beat-em-ups game. Well, at least we're going to get started. We're going to do this in a Construct 3. Okay, so you can head out to a construct.net. You can use the software for free.
There is no charge.
To make free games, at least. Okay, so here is what we're making today. I just recorded a video about the community settings. And I kind of show this. Okay, here it is. He can't punch yet, but he will be able to punch during this tutorial. Right, so we're going to start from scratch. You can find this right under the description below. So that's coming up next in the Sparkman channel. Okay, so let's launch Construct 3, and we are going to start from scratch. Let's go new project. I'm going to make this letterbox, optimize for pixel art, and create the project. Let me make this 640 by 480. There we go, hit enter. That is our stage. So let's insert our first sprite. Here's my sprite. And let's import our first sprite, which is our walking sprite. Let's call this stop. Okay. Now if you run this, you will notice that you have a black outline around here. Okay, let's make this a full screen. Just click on the just click anywhere and let's go to view. We're going to go to full screen mode. Scale outer, and that will give you full screen. Okay, so let's double click on the character again, and this time we're going to create a walking animation. Let's just call it walking. There it is. Let's import the sprites, import frames from file. We're going to import these two sprites. Let me delete this here. And that looks not too bad there. Let me change the speed to maybe 8. And let's loop this animation. Preview it. That looks not too bad. It's a terrible animation, but it's just for this example. We need another animation. Let's import the sprites. This is going to be our punching animation. Now the center is not what I want it to be. So let's fix that. Click on the edit image point. And our first frame is at 34. Okay, so let's make the 34 for the X on all of them. Very accurate way to center your sprite. Oh, here we go, 34. And 34 again. There we go. Maybe duplicate the last frame. And we're gonna call this punch. Punch, okay, and set the speed to maybe 8 as well. We don't want this loop. Now if you run this, you're going to notice that nothing happens, and that's because we haven't assigned any controllers to this. So let's go ahead and let's do that. Let's add a behavior to this. This will be an 8 direction object. Now if you run this, you will notice that your character does all kinds of strange things, okay, and that's not what we want. So let's change some settings here. First of all, let's change the speed. Maybe the speed should be like 150, acceleration to 2000, and the deacceleration to 2000 as well. Now I want this to be only four directions. And for the angle, we want no set angle. Run this again. And it looks a lot better now. You can go up and down, left and right, but the character doesn't turn around. Okay, so let's close this. Okay, so now we need a keyboard or a keyboard object. So we can use the keyboard. Let's go to events and let's add our first event. If a key is down, okay, it's gonna be the right key. If that happens, we want to change the animation. We want to change the animation to walking. Okay. And so let's copy this. And we're going to paste it. Change the direction to left. Now for this one here, we want to mirror this or flip it horizontally. And for the first one, we want to not mirror it, which you can select here. Try it out. Press right, left, and that works fine, except for the character doesn't start walking when we let go of the keys. So let's add a new condition. If the user is not holding down the right key, insert another condition. If the user is not holding down the left key as well. We're going to invert this. Invert it. So if the user is not holding down on these keys, then we're going to change the animation to stop. There we go. Try it out. And that works fine. Now we have to do the same thing for the up and down, but let's do left and right for now. So let's do the punch animation. So let's add a new event. If the user presses, let's say C, then we can change the animation sequence to punch. Try it out. Now this probably is not going to work. Let me just press the key. And it doesn't work. Okay. And that's because of this condition here. So let me insert another condition here. If animation punch is not playing. Animations is playing. Punch. Invert it. And let's try it out. Okay, that works fine. Except for the punching animation doesn't end. Let's add a new event. Under animation. Animation finish. Punch. When this animation finish, we want to change the animation back to stop. Set animation. To stop. Try it out. There we go. Do it for the left. Okay. Now you just need to add a sound effect. Alright, so we're going to continue this in the next video. Save your file and don't forget to smack the like button. And subscribe if you're not subscribed. Also, there is a bell next to the subscribe button, so make sure you hit the bell next to the subscribe button. See you in the next video.